OpenAI pulled off another major move early yesterday, launching its first-ever text-to-video model named Sora. People have been eagerly anticipating GPT-5, but the buzz around Sora's release rivals that of GPT-5. Previously, there was much speculation about whether Google's Gemini could overtake GPT-4 and if the world's tech giants could leapfrog in this wave of AI innovation. Now, it seems no one is paying attention to that anymore because OpenAI might just use Sora to surpass GPT for themselves. According to OpenAI, Sora is capable of quickly producing videos up to 1 minute long, featuring complex scenes with multiple characters, specific types of actions, and precise details of themes and backgrounds. From the 48 video demos updated on the company's official website, Sora not only accurately presents details but also creates characters with rich emotions. In terms of technology and working principles, OpenAI states that thanks to the transformer architecture, Sora has significant scalability. Moreover, building on previous research on DALL-E and GPT, it also utilizes DALL-E3's technique of rephrasing prompts to generate highly descriptive labels for training data, for the visual model. In August 2023, Runway Gen 2 was officially launched, marking the entry of AI-generated videos into the public eye. By the beginning of this year, countless products have emerged one after another, including Pika, Pixverse, SVD, Genmo, Moon Valley, among others. There are simply too many to count. It's noticeable that in the recent half year, the short videos we scroll through have included many that seem unnatural. A closer inspection reveals these are definitely not manually edited. First, there are no continuous shots longer than 4 seconds. Second, they appear very unnatural. These practical tools are mostly produced by small companies and are far from perfect. To call them imperfect would be an understatement, they are riddled with flaws. Ultimately, video content is a reproduction of the real world, which necessarily involves a great deal of interaction between objects, people, and people with objects, similar to footage captured on camera. When we watch movies or videos, we engage with these interactions, and few enjoy monologues. For instance, a glass falling off a table should shatter, a rubber ball dropped should bounce. However, when AI synthesizes such scenes, it fails to replicate these physical phenomena. When objects collide or overlap, AI often results in one object deforming, highlighting a key issue. Past AIs did not understand the rules of the real world. How big can the market be for videos that defy common sense? How high is the ceiling for AI that doesn't grasp basic physics? Is it hard to address this issue? Yes, very hard. Despite today's AI models simulating the human brain, they differ fundamentally in that AI lacks imagination. For example, envisioning the ripple effects of a slap across the face or predicting the spread of ripples from a torpedo in a pond, humans can anticipate what happens next, but AI cannot. No matter how sophisticated or fast, it remains incapable. Even the current model, Sora, falls short. Despite Sora's deep understanding of natural language, its ability to grasp prompts accurately, generate rich content, and even create multiple shots with consistent characters and visual styles, it still cannot accurately simulate complex physical phenomena because it doesn't understand causality. Examples include a cookie without bite marks after being bitten, confusion of left and right, not following specific camera trajectories, or even failing to recognize whether a shadow belongs to a person or an object. As a result, it produces videos that contravene physical laws. Given the drawbacks of previous text-to-video models, what exactly makes Sora stand out, and why has it garnered such a following? The reason is that it performs sufficiently well, at least much better than its peers. To use the words of Fortune magazine, it shifts the battle of generative AI to Hollywood. According to its official website, it can generate videos with multiple characters and specific types of motion, with accurate details in both subjects and backgrounds, and even understand how things exist in the physical world. Simply put, although it may not comprehend causality that requires imagination, it can replicate the most basic real-world scenes. The field of AI-generated video is less than a year old, so our expectations should not be too high. If we consider the content described above as the ultimate goal and the series of generative tools developed over the past year as prototypes, Sora sits somewhere in between. How does it achieve this? Who stands on the shoulders of giants? Sora primarily uses two technologies. One is the diffusion model, originally for converting text to images. In simple terms, it starts by generating a completely noisy image of the same vector dimensions as the target image. For example, if the target image is 256 x 256, the initial sample image must also be 256 by 256, and then through several denoising steps, the image gradually takes shape. The challenge is determining what to remove and what to keep, which of course requires training. Researchers first add noise to clear images step by step, as illustrated below in the reverse process known as reverse diffusion. Understanding these two steps is crucial to grasping what MIT Technology Review is discussing. Sora's team uses the technology behind DALL-E 3, the diffusion model, which can turn vague random pixels into images. The principle is straightforward, but it demands time and manpower. Another technology is the transformer neural network architecture, the T in GPT, generative pre-trained transformer. However, the transformer architecture is well known and has become mainstream in text and image generation. So why hasn't it been used in video generation, except by OpenAI? In technical terms, in the transformer architecture, the memory requirements of the full attention mechanism grow quadratically with the length of the input sequence. In layman's terms, the computational cost is too high. Even with Microsoft backing and significant funding, OpenAI is reluctant to spend excessively. Therefore, they developed a video compression network that first reduces the video data to a latent space, then generates patches from the compressed data, reducing the amount of input information and effectively decreasing the computational load. To better understand user intent, OpenAI integrates the video generation model directly into the proven GPT model framework, which is its unique advantage. Users' prompts are not directly given to Sora, but first elaborated by the mature GPT into precise and detailed text. Sora then generates more accurate videos frame by frame based on the detailed text provided by GPT. Personally, I believe this is Sora's greatest advantage over other models. Without a mature large model, other teams might solve some steps, but it's in vain. Overall, Sora's success was almost inevitable. Its impressive performance is largely due to OpenAI's past achievements, borrowing ideas, and essential architectures. This is what's known as a first-mover advantage, which is not just about the often-discussed monopoly issue. From one, two, from two, three, from three, the world is created. Looking at OpenAI's competitors around the world, all are stuck in generating text or images, with some not even achieving that and better off focusing on foundational work. Otherwise, by the time the first movers create everything, it will be too late. We can clearly feel that AI evolves faster than any other industry in the past. Perhaps, just maintaining a technological gap for 2 years could become an insurmountable chasm. The notions of closing the gap in a few months or overtaking on a bend are virtually non-existent. In conclusion, as mentioned earlier, Sora still has significant flaws. It can generate complex, exquisite, and sufficiently long videos, demonstrating a considerable improvement in AI's ability to understand the real world. However, this improvement still relies on extensive training rather than AI's intrinsic understanding of the world. Sora's video processing still has many limitations, including basic factual errors. Thus, while Sora is impressive, it doesn't yet qualify as the world model hotly debated these days. The notion that reality no longer exists certainly doesn't apply to the present, but who knows about the future? To most of us, Sora is just a text-to-video model. Its emergence signifies that most film and video production professionals will soon be out of work. But for the OpenAI team, it's more than that, it's a crucial step toward building AGI, artificial general intelligence. AGI's interaction with the world is not just through text, images, and voice, but also through more direct visual videos, which have been the most important way for humans to recognize and understand the world since ancient times. Hence, generating and understanding videos, as well as the physical world, are essential capabilities for future AGI. At this moment, we can only imagine the revolutionary impact generative AI will have on the film and game production industries. When AGI emerges, what can AI do, and how much will it impact the world? It's inevitable that it will be applied to embodied intelligence, or robots. Perhaps AI is indeed the technological singularity humanity has anticipated for decades. We know certain things will happen, but we can't imagine exactly what. Before OpenAI's Sora, Google released a new video generation model called VideoPoet on December 21 last year, capable of executing operations including text-to-video, image-to-video, and video stylization. The text-to-video software Pika, which became an overnight sensation, sparked a craze for AI video applications. In response to Sora's debut, Zhu Hongyi, the founder and chairman of 360 Group, expressed on Weibo on February 16 that this signifies the realization of AGI, artificial general intelligence, could be shortened from 10 years to just 1 year. Industry experts point out that video-centric generative AIs with text-to-video capabilities can significantly lower the barrier for creators. Video generation is poised to become a scenario with medium to high potential in the near future within the cross-modal generative domain, driven by changes in mainstream content forms brought about by various technologies. Jim Fan, a senior scientist at NVIDIA, commented that 2022 was the year of imagery, 2023 the year of sound waves, and 2024 will be the year of video. The ultimate goal of OpenAI's development of Sora is to achieve a digital twin. Though digital twin sounds sophisticated, it's quite straightforward, modeling and predicting the real world. The development of digital twins is generally divided into four stages: 1. The real world. 2. Creating digital reflections of the real world, categorized into real-time and delayed reflections. 3. Interaction between the real world and its digital reflection, leading to the expansion of digital threads, where the digital realm has the capability, possibly autonomously, to influence physical entity operations. 4. Digital physical twins gaining a degree of autonomy. 5. In the fifth stage, the level of autonomy continuously increases, allowing digital physical twins to act as autonomous agents in cyberspace, extending local data analysis to global scales. A simple example: before the internet, we lived in the physical world without a virtual counterpart, walking on real roads, marking the first stage. Then came the earliest map software, modeling real roads so we could view actual road conditions and traffic in the digital world. Road models were not updated in real time, but traffic conditions were. This represents the delayed and real-time reflections mentioned earlier, which is the second stage. Later, through various data analyses, map software could warn us of roads prone to accidents, marking the third stage where the digital model begins to influence our real-world actions. We are gradually entering the fourth stage, where map software displays real-time traffic conditions and advises us on routes based on data simulations, affecting us in real time. This real-time prediction exemplifies autonomy. Real-life decisions also influence the physical world model, such as someone walking through a field marked as a road by map software, later recommended to others. The fifth stage builds upon the maturity of the previous stages, emphasizing real-time functionality reliant on powerful sensor systems. In control theory, sensors and actuators are closely linked. The fifth stage highlights the role of actuators, where the digital brain's predictions and recommendations are executed by AI. This scenario corresponds to the ultimate goal of autonomous driving, where AI predicts the best route and my car follows its advice. Therefore, Elon Musk's initial interest in OpenAI and his subsequent pursuit of large models likely stem from this ultimate goal. Whether it's Google, OpenAI, or Musk's XAI, their ultimate aim is to construct a world model, possibly their version of AGI. In layman's terms, it's akin to an embodiment of strong AI, modeling the real world and using powerful computing to deduce the outcomes of different choices, thereby influencing the direction of the physical world and ultimately shaping the world according to its choices. The concept of AGI, or artificial general intelligence, once a distant dream, is now becoming a tangible reality, promising to reshape our world in ways we're just beginning to understand. Imagine a future where our cars navigate the chaos of city streets with ease, where decision-making is enhanced by a digital twin of the world, offering insights that were once beyond our grasp. As we close today's discussion, remember that we're not just passive observers of this technological evolution. We're participants, contributors, and, ultimately, the beneficiaries of a smarter, more connected world. The choices we make today will influence the development of these technologies and how they integrate into our lives. So, I encourage you to stay curious, stay informed, and engage with these emerging technologies. The future is not written, it's being coded, modeled, and predicted by the AI systems we're discussing today. And who knows? In this rapidly evolving landscape, the next breakthrough that brings us closer to AGI might just be around the corner. Thank you for tuning in, exploring the fascinating world of AI and its potential with me. If you found this journey as intriguing as I did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more deep dives into the future of technology. Together, let's keep pushing the boundaries of what's possible. Until next time, stay curious and keep dreaming of a world transformed by AI.